Okay, so you'll see on screen here I have a standard document. We've got some text in there, we've got some headings, numbered lists, images, that kind of thing. But let's pretend we wanted to password protect this because it could be a very kind of confidential document. Now, there's various options that you can follow for password protecting a document in Microsoft Word. You can set a password so that anybody trying to open the document needs to enter the password. You can then set another password to allow them to modify the contents of the document. And you can protect the document so that users can only do things like add comments or track changes. So I'm going to take you through the process just now, and I'm also going to show you how you can remove the password protection if you need to. Now, I'm using Microsoft Word for Mac. If you're a Windows user, the process is slightly different. Basically, to get to the password protect options, you need to click on File, then Info from the left-hand side, and then you should see Protect Document in the center of the screen, and you can go into there to protect your document. But for us Mac users, what we want to do is we want to go along to the Review tab at the top of the ribbon. Now, from the far right-hand side of the ribbon within the Review tab, you will see the Protect option. It has a down-pointing arrow which lets you know that there are further options within this particular option. So we can block authors, we can protect the document, open it as read-only always, and we can restrict permissions. I'm not going to touch on any of these three options just now. We're going to focus on protect the document. So I'm going to choose that option there. And then you will see you get the password protect menu appear on screen. So let's look at the groups right now. So security, the first group, set a password to open this document. So for anybody to be able to open the document, they're going to have to enter the password I've just typed. Now, what I need to do here is I need to press the return key because Microsoft Word is going to ask me to enter my password again to ensure that they match. If I put in a password which doesn't match, then click OK, it will tell me they don't match. So it's a kind of fail-safe here. You can't only enter the password once and then incorrectly enter that one. You need to make sure you have two matching passwords. So I'll put my password in correctly. And now we have set a password to open the document. The next one down, set a password to allow users to modify the document. Let me pop another password in there. Again, I've pressed the return key and I'm going to type my password again. Well, one thing it highlights here is it says, please remember your password. Lost passwords cannot be recovered. So when you're password protecting your documents, it's advised that you draw or jot down your passwords or keep them in a password management system of some sort, because if you forget the passwords or lose them, you will not be able to open the document. So be careful here if you are password protecting and make sure you write them down. So I'm going to click OK, and we now have a password to open the document, and we now have a password to modify it. Now, below that, you'll see there's a protection group. So what you can do is you can actually protect the document so that although users need a password to open and a password to modify, if we check the Protect Document option and then, for example, choose Comments, users will only be able to comment on this document, or it would only be read-only, or they could only use tracked changes. I'm going to choose Comments, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the OK button. Now, this document has now had password protection added to it. I'm going to save the document, and then I'm just going to close it down. Now here you'll see there's the document and it comes up with a password symbol on the little thumbnail for the document. The image below or the file below you'll see doesn't have that, so we can scan through it and we could open it without the password. But this new document does have password protection, so you can't even get a preview of its contents. I'm going to now double click on the file name and you will see before I can open it, I need to put in a password. If I put the incorrect password in, it tells me that I cannot open it. I'm going to go back and try and open it again, and this time I'm going to put in the correct password to open the file. And you see it tells me now that I'm able to open it. However, I need to put in a password to be able to modify the document. So if I don't know the password here to modify the document, then I can open it as read-only, and I wouldn't be able to do anything without then saving it. But for now, I'm going to put in the second password and click OK. And now you will see I can open the document. Now, although I had a password to allow me to modify it, you will see that I can't access any options in the ribbon here. Also, if I try and select any text and delete it, it doesn't let me do that. So all of the options in here, same with the insert menu, the draw menu, they are all disabled just now. But if I go into review, you'll see I do have an option to add comments. So I can comment on the document if I need to, okay? So that's what I'm allowed to do. It has given me the option to add comments. Okay, so let's say we have our document, but we now want to remove any of the password protection. So I'm going to go back up to the home. We'll just check. Yep, we definitely cannot do anything with this document. Let's go back into the review tab and back to the protect option and then protect document. Now, what we want to do here is we want to uncheck protect document for, and it will ask me to enter the password again. Now, the password you're entering there is the password to open the document. That's the first password you entered. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear the password to modify the document. So I will press delete, and I'm going to select the password here to open the document and also use delete. And then I'm going to click OK. And then you will see that the options have slowly returned. So if I go back into the insert menu, I have all of these options here. We have the home options and everything has come back. So now that we have edited the password protection on the document, last thing I'll do is I will quickly save the file, and then I'm going to close it down. And then you will see in here where we have the file, it is no longer protected with the password protect icon. You'll see we can cycle through and preview it. So we have safely removed the password protection from this document.